Hello, this is Hussam Hourani, and today we'll continue talking about text mining. And today we'll highlight the importance of topic modeling and how to do topic modeling in Orange Data Mining. Let's just directly go into Orange Data Mining, and we will use Corbus to connect to Grim Tail Selected. Of course, the title is title, and the use text features will be in the content. So this is the setup. We will, of course, you can view this in Corbus Viewer. Okay, this is the Corbus Viewer, and as you know that we have 44 different tails into two. These 44 tails categorized into two categories. The first one is, let me just select everything here, is tail of magic, and the second one is animal tails. So these are the topics that we're gonna do topic modeling with. So this is the first thing. The second thing we will do, pre-process. So we can do the, remove the stop words. So I'm gonna use the English, and I'm gonna use the stop word text, as you can see from here. I will eliminate these words, so apply, and the text is ready now to do topic modeling. So I can connect this to topic modeling. Okay, in topic modeling I will open it. Okay, it will take time because it's gonna process the text based on the selected method. Let us just wait till this open. Okay, and from this one we will use different widgets to explore the topic modeling. So by default it uses LSI. Of course you have LDA, and also you can have the hierarchical DP. So these are the methods that you can use in topic modeling: LSI, LDA, and hierarchical or HDP. So with this one, with the Latin semantic indexing, as you can see, we generated 11 topics. As you can see, you can decrease number of topics. These are the 11 topics, and per each topic, it brought the most important words. It will have, or you will have, words in green. They are positive words. And also we have words in red, which is negative words. So the green words are the highly representative in the documents, while in the topic, while the red words are the highly unrepresentative words in the topic. So these are the 11 topics that we generated. So from this one we can actually do a few things. First, we can do the Corbus Viewer. This is the Corbus Viewer, so we can select and we can check the Corbus Viewer. Okay, you can do the Corbus by Corbus, so you can view the whole Corbus, but you can see all the topics, the 11 topics, as you can see. So this tail, the grade for this tail is 32% related to this topic. Okay, and the most higher one is, I think, is this one. So I think it's topic number 6. So this document belongs to topic number 6 because it has the high measures, the high measure. Okay, this is the first one. So you can also browse on all other topics to see which topic this document or this tail belongs to. This is the first thing. Second thing, you can also connect to data table. This is the data table, and let's actually select topic to data. Maybe you can do this, so you can see that the selected topic, for example, the first one, this is the first one, it has all these words, as you can see, and the weights per word in this topic. So you can have the weights per each topic. So this is topic number one that we selected. Also, you can choose the whole corpus to data if you want. Let's just use corpus to data, and as you can see, you can have this is the tail of magic, etc., the abstract, and all topic 1 to 11, as you can see, and the weights, and the weights per each topic. So this, for example, is belonging to the higher measured topic in this list. Okay, so this is the topics and all the related corpus tales or documents. So we done the corpus viewer and we done the data table. Let's do something more advanced. Let's do MDS. So the MDS is very important because it can, you can see the measures. See, you can now do the BCA randomize and it will do the measures between the topics. So you can see that there are topics that are far from other topics, but anyway, you can select, for example, these topics and you can view them in data table. So this is, these are the topics, okay? Also, you can connect to box plot, okay? And from box plot, you can actually browse and see all the related data in the box plot. As you remember, we explained exactly what does this mean, as in standard deviation, the mean, the median, the minimum, the max, etc. So you can actually browse all these topics and see how these topics relates to each other in terms of the two categories, tales of magic and animal tales. This is in regard of box plot. We can also do the heat map. Let's do the heat map. This is the heat map, okay, and you can select from negative to positive, and you can browse this through data table also. Data table, as you can see here. Also, we will do the last one is word cloud. So this is the word cloud. So we can connect actually the corpus topic modeling to word cloud, and you can see all the highlighted words. And also you can actually do selection, select topic to topic, okay? And we can select this one to word cloud, and we can connect corpus to corpus, and we can browse now these with the word cloud. So I will open two windows. Okay, and as you can see, you can browse each topic and the related words. Okay, so this is the topic modeling, and these are the things that we implemented in topic modeling. I hope that the lesson was useful for all of you, and we'll see you in our next lesson. Till then, enjoy the Orange Data Mining, and we'll see you there.